Hidroelectrica. Mr. Bogdan Badea is with us tonight. Please, Mr. Badea, what are your plans, what are your thoughts on what the year will develop in the energy
sector? First of all, good evening, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here in person, an event on energy, because I think last one I participated to was almost 1 year ago, before the pandemic, first wave of pandemic comes in Romania. Yes, if we are looking back to 2020, it was a challenging year for sure for us. It was challenging because on one hand, the pandemic crisis affects our activities, affects from the perspective that we have to ensure the security of supply, and for that we had to adopt a lot of very quick measures to create the environment, especially in the important power plants that we are operating for isolating the personnel. So it wasn't a very easy task, but we managed to do it. In that period, basically two shifts from our five shifts in each power plant was isolated 14 days into the power plant, because our main concern was what is happening if a lot of people that operate the same power plant will get sick in the same time. And we are aware about our responsibility to ensure the security of supply for the whole country. This was the first priority, and we were able to pass this first obstacle. Of course, due to the pandemic crisis, also the price of electricity go down. The industrial consumers, most of them reduced their or closed their activity in that period. So from that point of view, the incomes that we are counting on wasn't at the level of the expectations. And the third, very important for us, at the first 6 months, it was an extreme drought comparing with our historical data. So we had to handle also this challenge. So in this environment, at the end of the year, looking back now, I'm very happy that we close with a good financial result above what we expected before the crisis in our budget. So this was a very important test for us in terms of resilience, and we passed this test. In the same time, we double the amount of investments in modernization and refurbishing our power plants. So it is quite an important achievement for us, taking into consideration the whole environment and the relation with our contractors that are also affected by the pandemic. And last but not least, it was the first important step that Hidroelectrica made last year in terms of M&A and diversifying our portfolio. We succeed to make our first acquisition, the first wind park of 108 megawatts at Crucea. It was a transaction that we signed last year, and we were able to conclude it a couple of weeks ago with all the approval necessary in order to be finished. So in this moment we are 100% shareholder of the first wind park in our portfolio. Of course it is an important step, but the next step will be to merge the two companies and to introduce the wind park in our portfolio and operate together with our hydropower plants. And we are not stopping here. We are looking to other projects in this moment, and we will not stop to invest in new capacities, because it is one of the most important goals of the whole energetic system in Romania. Of course, we'll keep the green level, so we are investing only in green energy, we are investing in wind, we are investing in solar, and we are very determined to invest in offshore wind. We are expecting that the legislation that will permit us to invest to be finished as quick as possible. And after that, for sure, Hidroelectrica, it will be part of the project that will be erected in the Black Sea. And I hope the whole potential of the Black Sea to be put as a priority for the Romanians, not just the wind potential, but also the gas potential, and with those two energy sources to be able to pass and to respond to the challenges that the Green Deal affect the whole Europe and basically replace the capacities that are not so friendly with the environment. Of course, the last one, and we make some jokes a little bit earlier with some of my colleagues that the most wanted event that all the people expect from Hidroelectrica is the IPO. So we were prepared from last year. Unfortunately, now that appeared a new legislation that put an interdiction in this respect. Now the parliament will change the legislation and immediately after will continue the IPO process. It is a normal step that a company like Hidroelectrica should make. Of course, all the investment plan, all our priorities, everything we want to do need a lot of capital. And I've told also in the past, Hidroelectrica is a big company, but if you want to do bigger thing, you need more capital, you need to find the right partners, and we need to use our potential in order to become not just a national important player, but also regional important player. So thank you very much.
Thank you. And yes, one very short, because you did not mention the water taxation issue. But this aside, a few words about the supply segment. Hidroelectrica entered a few months ago. How do you see this to evolve this year?
Yes, again, challenging, because we entered in this business not at the beginning of last year, but we are suppliers at a certain level for a couple of years, and I really believe in this business line. I encourage my colleagues to develop this business line. Coming back to the liberalized market offer for us a lot of opportunities. We have a very competitive price. Of course, it was a very tough returning from the regulated market to the free market, so we still have a lot of technical problem, because I think all the important supplier has this technical problem to absorb all the needs from millions of people who want to change the supplier in a very short period of time. We are investing a lot in this period in digitalization of the whole process, and I really believe that this line of business, it will be very successful for Hidroelectrica, and we'll have a lot of clients in Romania. Very happy clients, and with a good price, a competitive price, because at the end of the day, the consumer is the most important.